गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन. टुडे वी विल सॉल्व नेक्स्ट प्रॉब्लम ऑफ डबल कॉलम कैश बुक. सी द प्रॉब्लम. एंटर द फॉलोइंग ट्रांजैक्शंस इन द कैश बुक विथ कैश एंड बैंक कॉलम. मींस कैश एंड बैंक कॉलम्स मींस डबल कॉलम कैश बुक. जानेवरी 1st, कैश इन हैंड रुपीज 4000, कैश एट बैंक रुपीज 12000. दीज आर द ओपनिंग बैलेंसेस ऑफ कैश अकाउंट दैट इज कैश बुक कैश कॉलम and bank account that is bank cash book bank column are given. 4th January, sold goods for cash rupees 13,200. 5th, received from Suresh rupees 2,500. 6th, received a check from Ravi and immediately deposited it into bank rupees 6,400. 7th, salary paid to office staff by check rupees 7,600. 10th, paid Sudhir by check rupees 5,000. Next, 12th, paid for travelling expenses rupees 1,200. 15th January, cash purchases rupees 8,000, means goods purchased for cash rupees 8,000. 16th January, cash deposited into bank rupees 10,000. 20th January, cash sales rupees 15,100. Purchase machinery and payment made by cash rupees 6,800 on again 20th January as different date is not given. On 21st January, paid wages for erection of above machinery rupees 400. 22nd, withdrew from bank for office use rupees 7,500. 23rd, received a check from Anil and deposited it into bank rupees 4,600. 27th, Anil's check returned by bank dishonored rupees 4,600. 28th, purchased a computer and paid by check rupees 8,000. 30th January, paid charity rupees 120. 31st January, last entry, paid into bank, that is deposited into bank rupees 12,000. After reading the problem, you have to read every entry again and write its posting, that is whether this entry will be in receipt side or payment side. प्रत्येक एंट्री वाचून ती रिसीट साइडला येईल का पेमेंट साइडला येईल याचा विचार करून त्याच्यासमोर तुम्ही रिसीट साइड पेमेंट साइड आर आणि पी असं लिहू शकता प्रॅक्टिससाठी. आणि ती कॅश कॉलममध्ये येणार असेल तर आर ऑब्लिक कॅश, बँक कॉलममध्ये येणार असेल तर आर ऑब्लिक बँक, पेमेंट साइडला येणार असेल तर पी ऑब्लिक कॅश किंवा पी ऑब्लिक बँक असं तुम्ही लिहून घेऊ शकता पेन्सिलीने सॉल्व करण्यापूर्वी. आणि मग सॉल्व करून चेक करता येतं पटकन की आपण बरोबर केलं आहे की नाही. ओके, सो लेट्स सी. ओपनिंग बॅलन्सेस विल बी ऑन रिसीट साइड, दॅट इज डेबिट साइड ऑफ कॅश कॉलम अँड बँक कॉलम. ऑन 4th जानेवारी, सोल्ड गुड फॉर कॅश. वेन वी सोल्ड गुड्स विल रिसीव कॅश, सो रिसीट साइड कॅश कॉलम. ऑन 5th जानेवारी, रिसीव्ड फ्रॉम सुरेश, सो रिसीव्ड साइड कॅश कॉलम, that is debit side cash column. On 6th January, received a check from Ravi and immediately deposited into bank. As this check is immediately deposited into bank, entry will be on receipt side bank column. On 7th January, salary paid, so entry will be payment side and the payment made by check, so in bank column. On 10th January, paid Sudhir by check, so payment side bank column. 12th January, paid for traveling expenses, payment side cash column. 15th January, cash purchases, payment side cash column. 16th January, cash deposited into bank. This is a contra entry because we have removed cash from cash box and deposited it into bank. So I will explain it later while solving the cash book. 20th January, cash sales, so receipt side cash column. Purchased machinery, payment side cash column. 21st, paid wages for erection of above machinery, payment side cash column. 22nd, withdrew from bank for office use. This is again a contra entry. 23rd, received a check from Anil and deposited into bank. So receipt side, bank column. 27th, Anil's check returned dishonored. It will be entered on opposite side. So payment side, bank column. 28th, purchased a computer and paid by check. Payment side, bank column. 30th January, paid charity, payment side, cash column. 31st January, paid into bank, means again cash deposited into bank, means cash will be removed from cash box and it will be deposited into bank. So it is again a contra entry. So now let's solve this problem. So today we will solve problem of double column cash book. See the problem. Enter the following transactions in the cash book of cash and bank column. This cash book has debit side and credit side. On debit side, date particulars, that is receipts, V number, LF, cash and bank column. Credit side, there will be same columns. Okay. Now, on debit side, we will enter all cash receipts or bank receipts. Means, if cash received, we will enter amount in cash column. If cash is deposited into bank, we will enter the amounts in bank column. म्हणजे रोख पैसे मिळाले तर कॅश अकाउंटमध्ये, म्हणजे कॅश कॉलममध्ये जमा होतील. कॅश कॉलम हा कॅश अकाउंट आहे आपला. आणि बँक कॉलम हा बँक अकाउंट आहे, ॲज गुड ॲज बँक कॉलममध्ये बँकेमध्ये रोख पैसे काही जमा झाले, चेक जमा झाला, तर त्याची एंट्री बँकेमध्ये होईल, बँक कॉलममध्ये होईल. पेमेंट साईडला ऑल पेमेंट्स विल बी एंटर्ड, कॅश पेमेंट्स अँड बँक पेमेंट्स. कॅश पेमेंट्स विल बी इन कॅश कॉलम, बँक पेमेंट्स विल बी इन बँक कॉलम. ओके, सो लेट्स स्टार्ट नाउ. सी युअर प्रॉब्लेम. जानेवारी 1st, कॅश इन हँड अँड कॅश ॲट बँक इज गिवन 4000 अँड 12000. दीज आर द ओपनिंग बॅलन्सेस ऑफ कॅश अँड बँक कॉलम. ओके, सो 2017 जानेवारी 1st, टू बॅलन्स ब्रॉट डाउन. कॅश बॅलन्स इज 4000 अँड बँक बॅलन्स इज 12000. These are the closing balances of last month, that is December and December 2016, and opening balances of January, month of January 2017. Okay, now next. On 4th January, sold goods for cash rupees 13,200. Sold goods for cash means we have sold goods and we are receiving cash. So entry will be on receipt side. So on 4th January, two sales account, as it is cash sale, it means amount received in cash, amount will be in cash column, not in bank column. Next, on 5th January, received from Suresh rupees 2500. Again we are receiving cash from Suresh. So entry will be on receipt side, as we have received cash from Suresh to Suresh's account. We are receiving cash from Suresh rupees 2500. So amount will be in cash column 2500 and dash in bank column. Okay. Next, on 6th, received a check from Ravi and immediately deposited it into bank. We have received a check from Ravi for rupees 6400 and we have deposited that check immediately into bank. So our bank balance will increase. Okay, entry will be on receipt side to Ravi's account. We have received check and deposited immediately into bank account. So our bank balance will increase by rupees 6400. Next, now on 7th January, salary paid to office staff by check rupees 7600. We are paying salary to office staff. So entry will be on payment side. On 7th January,
by salary account 7600 will be in bank column because salary was paid by check 7600. Next entry now. On 10th January paid Sudhir by check rupees 5000. Paid Sudhir by check rupees 5000. So he will be on payment side. 10th January, on 10th January by Sudhir's account. We have paid the amount by check and the amount is rupees 5000. So 5000 will be in bank column. When we pay something by check, amount will always be in bank column. Okay, because that amount will go from bank or bank account, business bank account. Next, 12th, paid for traveling expenses 1200. So on 12th January, by traveling expenses account, amount is 1200 and dash in bank column. Next entry now. Cash purchases rupees 8000 on 15th January. So on 15th January, cash purchases means goods purchased for cash. So we are taking goods and giving cash. So entry will be on payment side. And heading will be by purchases account. And amount is rupees 8000. And as it is cash purchases, amount will be in cash column. Amount is not paid by giving check, but it is cash is given here for purchase of goods. Okay. Next. On 16th, cash deposited into bank rupees 10,000. On 16th, cash deposited into bank rupees 10,000. Cash deposited into bank means first we have to remove from cash box cash rupees 10,000 and then we will deposit it into bank. मी तुम्हाला सांगितल्याप्रमाणे cash आणि bank column हे दोन खिशासारखे आहेत. एका खिशातून म्हणजे कॅश बॉक्समधनं 10,000 रुपये काढले जाणार आहेत आणि बँकेत भरले जाणार आहेत. म्हणजे एका खिशातनं पैसे बाहेर जातील, एका खिशामध्ये पैसे येतील असा त्याचा अर्थ आहे. ओके, म्हणजेच कॅश बॉक्समधनं 10,000 बाहेर गेलेत असं दिसलं पाहिजे, मीन्स पेमेंट झालं असं दिसलं पाहिजे. सो एंट्री विल बी ऑन पेमेंट साईड इन कॅश कॉलम रुपीज 10,000 बिकॉज वी हॅव रिमूव्ह रुपीज 10,000 फ्रॉम कॅश बॉक्स. देन सेकंड पोस्टिंग विल बी on receipt side because we have deposited that cash rupees 10,000 into bank. So we will write that amount in bank column and our bank balance by will increase by rupees 10,000. Understood? So this is called as contra entry. First we will enter here on 16th January na? Yes, on 16th January cash deposited into bank. So on 16th January we will remove cash 10,000 to deposit into bank. So by bank account, here we will write contra entry and we will remove 10,000 from cash box. म्हणजे कॅश बॉक्समधून 10,000 रुपये बाहेर काढलेले आहेत. Now we will deposit that 10,000 into bank account on 16. So to cash account, cash will be deposited into bank and in bank column we will write 10,000. It means we have removed rupees 10,000 from the cash box and we have deposited rupees 10,000 into our bank account. So our bank balance will increase by rupees 10,000. Understood? Next. On 20th, cash sales rupees 15,100. Cash sales rupees 15,100. Cash sales on 20th January. So entry will be on receipt side as we are receiving cash by selling goods. To sales account and amount will be in cash column rupees 15,100. Next entry now. On 20th January again, as date is not given, purchased machinery and payment made by cash rupees 6,800. Purchased machinery. So we are purchasing an asset called as machinery. NT will be on payment side because we are making payment by check. So on payment side on 20th January, by machinery account, amount will be in bank column 6800 as we are making payment by check. Okay. Next, on 21st, they told us that paid wages for erection of above machinery rupees 400. Okay. So on 21st, they have made the payment of rupees 400 for, sorry, payment made by cash, they told us. I'm very sorry. I thought the payment was made by check. They told that purchase machinery and payment made by cash. Okay, so amount will be in cash column. Now they told us that on 21st, they spent rupees 400 for erection of machinery. Erection charges or installation charges of machinery will always be debited to machinery account because that amount will be included in amount of the machinery. So here on 21st, we will again debit machinery account, by machinery account, and amount will be in cash column rupees 400 because we have spent erection charges. We can write here as narration erection charges. Okay, लक्षात ठेवा, ज्यावेळेला आपण मशीनरी परचेस करतो त्यावेळेला ती मशीनरी जागेवर बसून ती वर्किंग पोझिशन मध्ये येईपर्यंत मशीनरीवर जो खर्च होतो तो मशीनरीच्या किमतीत ऍड केला जातो. जसं आपण व्हेकल परचेस करतो त्यावेळेला ऑन रोड किती रुपयाला पडली असं व्हेकलची प्राइस ठरवतो, त्याप्रमाणे टोटल मशीनरीची प्राइस इन दिस केस विल बी 6800 प्लस 400, दॅट इज 7200 अल्टिमेटली. ओके, नेक्स्ट एंट्री. नाव withdrew from bank for office use rupees 7500 on 22nd January. Withdrew from bank for office use rupees 7500, not for personal use. They have withdrawn rupees 7500 from the bank and brought that amount into cash box for office use. So see, again this is a contra entry because we are removing some amount from one pocket and we are bringing that amount in other pocket. Okay, so we are withdrawing rupees 7500 from bank. First we have to withdraw the amount from bank here. So entry will be on payment side. On date is 22nd January. So on 22nd January we will withdraw rupees 7500 from bank. So by cash account, contra entry, amount will be in bank column. As we are withdrawing cash from bank, our bank balance will reduce by rupees 7500. And now we will brought that amount into cash box for office use. So our cash balance should increase by that amount. So on 22nd, to bank account, contra entry, and amount will increase in the cash box by rupees 7500. Okay, next entry. Now this is again a contra entry. Banketun paise bahar gelele ahet, kadlele ahet ani cash box madhe alele ahet because cash withdrew for office use ase sangitlele ahet. Next, 23rd, received a check from Anil and deposited it into bank rupees 4600. We have received one check from Anil. So on 23rd, to Anil's account, we have received check here, and as we have immediately deposited the check into bank worth rupees 4600, amount will be on in bank column, not in cash column. Okay, so we are received check from Anil and immediately deposited into bank, and we assume that our bank balance now will increase by 4600. Now the next entry. On 27 January, Anil's check returned by bank dishonored. Anil's check returned by bank dishonored 4600 rupees. See, here we have deposited Anish's check into bank and we have assumed that our bank balance has been increased by ₹4,600. But now on 27th, bank informed us that this check has been dishonored. याचा अर्थ अनिलच्या चेकचे पैसे आपल्या अकाउंटवर जमा झालेलेच नाहीत. मे बी अनिलच्या अकाउंटला पैसे नसतील, मे बी त्याची सिग्नेचर रॉंग आली असेल, मे बी त्यांनी काहीतरी लिहिलं नसेल चेकवर डेट एक्सेट्रा. अशा काही कारणांनी बँक आपल्या खात्यावर 7600 rupees आपल्या अकाउंटवर जमा करत नाही. ओके, दिस इज कॉल्ड ॲज डिसऑनर ऑफ चेक. आता हा चेक डिसऑनर झाल्यामुळे आपण इथे पैसे जे जमा झालेले दाखवलेले आहेत ते आपल्याला कॅन्सल करायला पाहिजेत. आणि अकाउंटन्सीमध्ये हे पैसे कॅन्सल करण्यासाठी ही एंट्रीज खोडून टाकली जात नाही. तर टू मेक द इफेक्ट नील वी हॅव टू पास द एंट्री दॅट इज अपोजिट एंट्री. ओके, आपल्याला अपोजिट एंट्री पास करायला पाहिजे, म्हणजेच आपल्याला अपोजिट साईडला एंट्री करायला पाहिजे. म्हणजे चेक आला आणि चेक गेला म्हणजे अमाऊंट जमा झाली नाही असा त्याचा अर्थ होईल. सो ऑन 27th बाय अनिल्स अकाउंट वील राईट नॅरेशन, सम इम्पॉर्टंट नॅरेशन्स वी हॅव टू राईट. चेक डिसऑनर्ड, दिस नॅरेशन विल बी फॉर अवर रेफरन्स, मीन्स अकाउंटंट्स रेफरन्स. बाय अनिल्स अकाउंट चेक डिसऑनर and we will write now amount ₹4,600 in bank column. So and effect of this entry will be nil by passing the opposite entry. Okay, so for dishonor of check we have to pass the opposite entry and make the entry in cash book on opposite side. Understood? Next, on 28th purchased a computer and paid by check ₹8,000. So we have purchased an asset. So on 28th we can say office equipments account or we can also say by computer account. Computer is an office equipment, so by office equipment account and to bracket computer purchase, this way we can also write. And the amount is ₹8,000 and the payment made by check. So in bank column ₹8,000. Okay, now next entry. On 30th January paid charity ₹120. So on 30th January by charity account ₹120 in cash column dash in bank column. Next and last entry now. On 31st January paid into bank ₹12,000. Paid into bank ₹12,000 means deposited into bank ₹12,000. So again, see, again this is a contra entry because they told us that paid into bank ₹12,000 means deposited इंटू बँक ₹12,000. 12,000 रुपये बँकेत भरले म्हणजे ते कुठनं हवेतनं तर येणार नाही आहेत. जादूनी कॅशबॉक्समधनं साठलेले 12,000 रुपये काढले आणि बँकेत भरले असा त्याचा अर्थ होतो. म्हणजे पुन्हा एकदा एका पॉकेटमधनं पैसे काढले, दुसऱ्या पॉकेटमध्ये घातले. फर्स्ट वी हॅव टू रिमूव फ्रॉम कॅश ₹12,000. सो ऑन 31st आय थिंक, येस 31st we have to remove from cash box ₹12,000 to deposit it into bank. Contra entry, we will remove ₹12,000 from cash box and now we will deposit it into bank. So receipt side bank column on 31st deposited into bank. So to cash account contra entry and amount will be in bank column, that is ₹12,000. By this entry, our cash balance, that is cash in cash box, will decrease by ₹12,000 and cash in bank account will increase by ₹12,000 because we have deposited this cash into bank. We have removed the cash from the cash column and deposited into bank column. Understood? This is the contra entry. This is the concept of contra entry we have learned in this problem. And now, just like ledger accounts, we have to tally this cash book. Okay? So, let's tally them. Let's tally now. First, we will tally debit side cash column with credit side cash column. Let's make the total of amounts of cash column first. So, the total is 42,300. Yes, it is correct, 42,300. And credit total is 38,520. Okay, so mothi total apan doni kade lenar ahot, obviously. So mothi total 42,300. Now from this amount hi debit total hai, ti mothi ahe mhanun apan doni kade lili ahe. Tyachyatun credit chi total ji 38,520 ali ahe ti apan less karnar ahot. 38,520 amount will be 3780. This is the balance we will write on credit side because credit total is less. ज्या साइडची टोटल लेस आली आहे त्या साइडला आपण बॅलन्स लिहितो, म्हणजे त्या तो बॅलन्स आणि या सगळ्या अमाउंट मिळून याची पण टोटल 42,300 होईल. दिस इज द बॅलन्स. ओके, ऑन 31 जानेवारी, 31 इज द लास्ट डेट ऑफ जानेवारी मंथ. सो ऑन 31 जानेवारी बाय बॅलन्स कॅरीड डाऊन. And now cash balance is 3780. In the same way, we will tally bank column debit side with bank column credit side. And debit total is 45,000. Credit total is 32,700. So 45,000. Is the total receipts into bank. From that 45,000 we have spent rupees 32,700. That is total payments are of 32,700. So the difference will be 12,300. Buy balance carried down. Cash balance 3780. Bank balance 12,300. This is the closing balance of month of January and now that will be the opening balance of February 1st. So, we will write on the opposite side two balance brought down. Cash balance is 3780 and bank balance is 45,000. In this way, they will start now entering transactions of February month in the next month of cash book. Okay, manje actual business madhe January zalyavar account tally kela jato, February madhe entries kela jatat, puna February ta account tally kela jato, asha paddhatine cash book chalu rahato 31st March paryanta. 31st March la final tally kela jato ya year sathi. Understood? Now as I told you, while solving the simple cash book, in simple cash book that cash book was used as journal as well as ledger account, that is cash account. Now in double column cash book, as there are two columns, cash and bank, so in this cash book cash column is your cash account, so we will not prepare again cash account into ledger, and bank column is our bank account. Okay, so we will not solve, means prepare cash account or bank account again in the ledger, but we have to prepare other accounts into our ledger. So let's see how many accounts we have to prepare. 1st January, 4th January sales, so we have to prepare sales account here. Okay, then on 5th January Suresh account, so we have to prepare Suresh account. 6th January Ravi's account is new account, so we have to prepare Ravi's account, third account. After 6th, entry of 7th, salary, सो फोर्थ अकाउंट इज सैलरी, फिफ्थ अकाउंट इज सुधीर, आफ्टर दैट ट्वेल्थ ट्रैवलिंग एक्सपेंसेस अकाउंट, आफ्टर दैट 15 परचेसेस अकाउंट वी हैव टू प्रिपेयर, आफ्टर दैट 16 कैश अकाउंट. We will not prepare cash account or bank account because this is our cash account and bank account also, that is our cash book. So after 16, on 20 machinery account, okay, then again on 20th sales account, we have prepared already sales account, so we will not prepare sales account. On 25th, this is included in machinery account. On 22nd, cash and bank account we will not prepare. After that on 23rd, Anil, we have not prepared Anil's account, so we have to prepare 9th account, that is Anil's account. 27th, again Anil's account will not prepare. Now 28th, computer account will be 10th account. Then on 30th, charity account will be 11th account. And then bank and cash account will not prepare again. Okay, so this is our cash account, this is debit side of cash account, this is credit side of cash account, this is debit side of bank account, this is credit side of bank account. So in ledger we will prepare only these 11 accounts, and just like simple cash book, we have to enter the second posting into respective ledger accounts. Okay, तुम्हाला मी या प्रॉब्लेममध्ये तोंडी आपण कसं पोस्टिंग करणार आहोत ते सांगणार आहोत. मी तुम्हाला ऑलरेडी शिकवलं लेजर अकाउंटमध्ये कसं पोस्टिंग करायचं. सो यू हॅव टू प्रिपेअर ऑल द लेजर अकाउंट, दॅट इज 11 लेजर अकाउंट्स इन युअर नोटबुक, अँड पोस्ट दीज एंट्रीज, दॅट इज मेक सेकंड पोस्टिंग ऑफ दीज एंट्रीज. ओके, सी दिस इज द फर्स्ट एंट्री, अमाऊंट इज इन द कॅश कॉलम, सो दीज एंट्रीज रिलेटेड टू कॅश अकाउंट. सो डेबिट साइड ऑफ कॅश अकाउंट टू सेल्स अकाउंट मीन्स क्रेडिट साइड ऑफ सेल्स अकाउंट देर विल बी बाय कैश अकाउंट. अंडरस्टूड? देन द सेकंड एंट्री, इन दिस एंट्री डेबिट साइड ऑफ कैश अकाउंट टू सुरेश अकाउंट 2500 मीन्स क्रेडिट साइड ऑफ सुरेश अकाउंट बाय कैश अकाउंट 2500. अंडरस्टूड? हियर डेबिट साइड दिस अमाउंट इज इन बैंक कॉलम, सो इट इज बैंक अकाउंट. So debit side of bank account to Ravi's account 6400. So credit side of Ravi's account by bank account to 6400. कळतंय तुम्हाला? कॅश कॉलम मध्ये जे अमाऊंट्स आहेत त्याचं सेकंड पोस्टिंग त्या त्या अकाउंटला कॅश अकाउंट नावाने होणार आहे. बँक कॉलम मध्ये ज्या एंट्रीज आहेत त्याचं सेकंड पोस्टिंग रिस्पेक्टिव्ह अकाउंट्सना बँक अकाउंटच्या नावाने होणार आहे. कळतंय? दिस इज द थर्ड एंट्री. देन हियर द फोर्थ एंट्री, क्रेडिट साइड ऑफ, सी अमाउंट इज इन बैंक कॉलम, सो क्रेडिट साइड ऑफ बैंक अकाउंट 7600. सो डेबिट साइड मीन्स क्रेडिट साइड ऑफ बैंक अकाउंट बाय सैलरी अकाउंट 7600. सो डेबिट साइड ऑफ सैलरी अकाउंट टू बैंक अकाउंट 7600. अंडरस्टूड? इन दिस वे वी हैव टू मेक सेकंड पोस्टिंग ऑफ ऑल दीज 11 ट्रांजैक्शंस. This bank column and this bank account and this cash account, or here contra entries are there. हे जे बँक अकाउंट आणि कॅश अकाउंट आहेत त्यांचं सेकंड पोस्टिंग इथल्या इथे झालेलं आहे. एक कॅश अकाउंटमध्ये झालंय, एक बँक अकाउंटमध्ये झालंय. त्याचा वेगळा अकाउंट उघडून परत सेकंड पोस्टिंग आणखी होणार नाही. तुम्हाला कळतंय? हा कॅश अकाउंट आणि बँक अकाउंट आहे. कॉन्ट्रा एंट्रीचं पोस्टिंग एक कॅश अकाउंटमध्ये एक बँक अकाउंटमध्ये अपोजिट साईडला झालेलं आहे, त्यामुळे त्या एंट्रीचं काहीही पोस्टिंग होणार नाही. फक्त हे जे 11 अकाउंट्स आहेत ते वेगळे आहेत, त्यामुळे इथे फर्स्ट पोस्टिंग झालेलं आहे. सेकंड पोस्टिंग तुम्हाला त्या लेजर अकाउंटमध्ये करायचं आहे आणि लेजर अकाउंट टॅली करायचं आहे. नाऊ दिस इज युअर जॉब. इफ देर इज एनी डाऊट यू कॅन आस्क मी. ओके, दॅट्स ऑल फॉर टुडे.